Hey guys, we play PC only here, and today I'm going to be playing a bit of Battlefield 3, as you can all see, and we're going to be talking about the some new DayZ 3 patch notes. So here we go then. They're adding some new weapons in. They fixed the M40 OA3, because I know that was overpowered and the range and things were broken with that, and it was just becoming a too overpowered gun. What else have they got? They got that. There's a weapon they're adding in, the SA-58P EP-1. That's going to be a military gun, so you only be able to find that at the military spawn loots. We're adding in the SA-58V EP-1 military, same, be able to find that at like a barracks or a deer stand or someplace like that. They're adding in a SA-58V RCO EP-1. It says military S, so I don't know what the S stands for. What else are adding in? They're adding in the SA-58V CCO EP-1 military S. They're adding in some of the G36Cs, as I can see. We've got the C, A and K versions of it. So first off, we're adding in the G36C camo. We'll be able to find that only at a helicopter crash site. And then we've got the G36A camo helicopter crash site, as all the G36s are going to be helicopter crash sites. We've got the G36CK camo. No, G36K camo, sorry about that guys, we got a heli crash site, and there's the weapon M40 OA3 military S. They're adding in some new vehicles as well. They're adding in the Humvee, and they are re-adding in the I think it's a 5-man little bird, the MH6JDZ, and there's going to be a new ability to flip ATVs. Zeds are now going to be spawning when you're in vehicles. So if you guys are thinking, whoa, there's a player here, and you're driving through nowhere, through like bloody like Krasnov or something like that, you don't know if there's a player there, but it's going to be a low chance, because zombies are now going to be spawning whilst you're in the vehicle. Zombies now have the ability to chain, no, whatever. Zombies now have the ability to damage vehicles. This is limited to glass only. Once glass is destroyed, players will be able to be damaged. So like you'll be able to lose blood and get hit and bleed. Zombies now have the ability to pull you out from the what? Oh, I just read that right. Zombies now have the ability to pull you open from vehicles. So that, I think that means like, what the hell? Vehicles, that's going to be quite interesting. So they're going to, I think they're going to be able to pull you out of like an ATV or a motorbike or something. So that would be pretty good. There's going to be new loading screens added. There's going to be remapped GUI icons to now empty as you lose the relevant item, blood, food, water. Basically they're the icons on the right of your screen. Chopper weapons can now be reloaded. Fair enough, they're going to be adding in chopper weapons that are going to be able to be reloaded. They're adding in the UH-60 wreck. I've already got that on my server, and that you get some pretty decent guns off there, guys, so it's worth it going to check it out. Where am I? 2 seconds, let me get up to date with this. Okay, right. The British Armed Forces L85A2 RIS CWS is now been replaced, because I know you guys did love the L85A2. It's now been replaced with the BAF L85A2 RIS Hollow. That's going to be able to find a heli crash site. So I know with the CWS, or the how you guys want to pronounce it, you could not see. It was just overpowered. Like you'd be killed with like 400 meters plus with it, and it's just crazy. It really used to annoy me as well. What else we got? The loading screens are going to be a lot faster according to this. So yeah, they've added a much faster login process. Advantages: login speed up, because I know when you get into servers, and hopefully that will fix the desync as well. When you get into servers, they're like, it takes you like 40 minutes to even get in it, and you're stuck on something. There's limited amount of ammo found with weapons. There's already kind of been limited amount of ammo with weapons. Updated gender selection images. I take it that's like your selection. You pick male or female. And there's now, you can now get infected. Updated the infection chance during Zed's attack from 1 in 1,000 to 1 in 500. Okay, so that means you can get infected and turn half zombie. They've changed the loot tables. to increase the supply of antibiotic drops, because I know they're very rare antibiotics. Combat mode is now affected by everything you do and everything done to you. Example, any kind of damage, so that's a bit suck. So remember now, if you get hit by a zombie and you can log, so now you're not going to be able to log. Max local Zeds, updated based on the area you're in. Example, city capitals, where city capitals like 70 city, and then villages 60 zombies, and then 50 old local Z count was 40 at any location that has buildings. So there's going to be up to 40 zombies that have buildings. Okay, that's going to be not very good. The MI17 DZ and the UH1H has to max ammo, max 100 rounds. So fair enough, it's only got 100 rounds now. 100 rounds per gun. Fair enough. UH1 crash site's no longer all spawn on. Where's that bug? All spawn on server. Start, but throughout the game. What else we got? Damage processing for zombie attacks with pre-built weighted. Is that armor? Can't read today. With pre-built weighted arrows. Advantages: speed up and saves a lot of CPU cycles. Fair enough. Loot chance reworked. Built should now be instant spawn loot. That's gonna be pretty good. And anyway, where was we? They fixed a few things as well. The zombies' hearing should now be fixed. That's when you'd be like 200 meters away from a zombie, and you'd be like crouching or walking, and they will get angry and just go nuts at you and try and kill you. Yeah, that's been fixed, and that now you shouldn't get as much aggro. They fixed temperature icon from ranges from now ice blue, cold to red hot. So that'll be red, will be hot. Correct.